Most people are asleep. They walk through this world either oblivious or apathetic to what goes on around them. They all assume that the world is a safe, kind, accommodating place that revolves around them and their pathetic little lives. They are sheep who stumble through life without ever questioning the benevolence of the farmer raising them for the slaughter. But in truth, we live in a dark and dangerous world. A world where good and evil are locked in perpetual conflict. Where powerful men manage people like pawns on a chessboard for their own gain, and dark forces work behind the scenes to lay the groundwork for our destruction. The pervasive wickedness of the elite flies right over the heads of the flock. But to we noble sheepdogs on the fringe, those of us who are ever vigilant and attuned to the world's dangers, the signs of their wrongdoing are all around us. Once you've seen behind the veil and felt the compulsion to defend the innocent and speak truth to power, it is impossible to back down when confronted with such villainy. For where lies and darkness dwell, the brilliant light of truth and justice must be shown. And few things in life are as satisfying as holding that brilliant light. for the sake of the innocent who lack strength, the conformists who lack daring, and the selfish who lack moral fortitude. It is of the utmost importance that we conscientious few step up and be willing to do whatever it takes to defend our lives and our liberty. Once the fires of liberty have been lit in your mind, they consume everything in their path. They dominate your every waking thought, become the filter through which all relationships must pass, and completely fill up your Facebook timeline. They drive you to leave no stone unturned, no questions unasked, and no beliefs unstated. They force you to seek answers for everything and expose every ounce of corruption you unearth. The fires of liberty don't just stimulate us intellectually. They can also embolden us and drive us to do things we would have never thought that we were capable of. Thank you. Obsession can be a good thing in the right circumstances. It helps us accomplish the things that no one else can, seek the truths that no one else wants to, say the things that no one else is willing to say. But obsession isn't always healthy, because sometimes it can get us into trouble. The problem many of us have is that we really aren't so different than the rest of the sheep. Despite all our protests to the contrary, and our best attempts to trick even ourselves, we still think that we are the center of the universe, just like the rest of society does. We end up making the arrogant assumption that we are either important enough for the powers that be to want us silenced, or brilliant enough to discover something that no one else could. Oftentimes, we even think that we are both. Where we really run into trouble, though, is that more often than not, this assumption causes us to attribute to malice events that are rightly explained by coincidence and stupidity. We'll be right back. in our futile pursuit of increasingly labyrinthian and esoteric conspiracies, we lose sight of the all-too-real evil that openly permeates our society. Our increasingly outlandish claims and erratic behavior end up driving away even those who should be on our side. Smoke clears and the dust settles. We're left staring into the barrel of a harsh reality. We've just been running scared of our own shadow the whole time.